Hey folks, Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a look at a classic LEGO space set from 1981. This one came with 170 pieces. It's called All Terrain Vehicle. This is another of those sets that I really wanted as a kid back then in the early 1980s. Saw this thing in pictures, thought it looked really, really cool, and just continued to look at it. Never actually got it until now. So it's definitely a privilege to be able to finally kind of fulfill an old small dream of sorts, being able to get this set. It's not that big of a set, but I'm a big fan of off-road vehicles in general, so to get an off-road sci-fi vehicle is a nice thing. It has a really nice front end to it. I like how it's all pointed down towards the front like that, from the top and from the bottom. It has a little bit of a kind of a combination of a earth based all-terrain vehicle with a spaceship kind of mixed together. Little ladder stairs on the side to help you get up inside of it. This is actually the driving compartment. But the thing that's most interesting about this to me is something that I never realized looking at pictures of this for so long as a kid. This is actually a two-in-one set. All this back here is a science lab module, which is intended to be dropped off. And it's very simple how it gets dropped off. It just gets dropped off. So it just opens up in the back and that just gets left behind like that. It's on four little stands like that. And you look inside, you've got a nice little interior space, one single swiveling chair, a bunch of panels. You can see two against the back wall there, or I guess that's really the front wall on the inside. And then one on either side. Good placement of windows, got the train style windows, got printed bricks on the outside giving it extra detail. You've got these little lights on the sides, which are actually functional. They don't actually create light. You can see a little bit of light coming through the one on the opposite side, but those actually deal with the pickup and drop off mechanism, as this is also part of that mechanism as well. So let's look at that again, because you can pick this thing up. So this vehicle without the module on the back really doesn't look all that interesting. It's kind of weird that it has large like rocket motors on the back, a little bit more spaceship-like again, but it's a vehicle. It's a land vehicle, so I don't quite understand the idea of rocket motors on the back. But as a kid, I sure did like that look. But just like this, it's so empty and open. It's really, really weird. It's I guess some kind of, it kind of is supposed to look like some sort of land tug or tractor kind of vehicle. So it's different, but I think it kind of makes sense. You open these up, drive this up onto here. As these close up, they're actually pinching in underneath these inverted slopes. You can see it's actually lifting by pinching that up. And the light over here on the side, the little trans piece, is actually climbing. You see how that's climbing up as I close this in? It's climbing up and it's going to stop. Everything just locks together. It's a brilliant mechanism. So simple, actually lifts the thing off the ground and puts it perfectly into place. You just back up. It doesn't even have to be perfect how you back up to it. And now you're ready to drive off. That is such a nice mechanism. It's so simple. And here's a look at the kind of driving compartment. So there you can see how you can see down really well, and just really good visibility, and just holds onto one single minifig. And there's what he would look like in place. See, he gets covered nicely, has good view from the front. He can see down. Yeah, pretty cool. Only thing that I don't like here is the fact that this is kind of open on the top, which, I feel like they could have done something that looked realistic or appropriate to that era by using some period appropriate pieces. Change out all of this up here except for one, for tiles. Just put tiles up here and just leave one stud on either side. And I just put this together really quick just to give an example of what it could look like with something on top. Imagine this was tiles down here, so there would be no gap, but I just feel like it would look a little bit better with a roof over the head of the guy like that, something like that. A lot of different ways that it could be done, but I just thought that might look a little more cool. And this set does come with two minifigs. You get one in red and one in white. The one with white here has most of the gold just kind of rubbed off over time, as is fairly common for these, but they do have the period appropriate helmets on, One's got the walkie-talkie, got the air tanks back there. It's just standard fare, a little bit of breakage in the feet. You know, it's just normal wear and tear. It's good to see that these things have actually been used. It means they've actually been played with and brought some smiles and happiness and good exercise of imagination to some kids in the past. The one thing that's a little bit of a miss with the design of the set going with the minifigs is that in order to put a guy in the seat, you have to take his air tanks off, and they don't give you a good place to put the air tanks on the inside. So I guess you just have to kind of hang them off one of these antenna pieces on the side. That kind of works. Instruction sheet have, but it's in really bad shape. It's all taped up, but you know, it was good enough to put the thing together. It's all there, so I really can't complain about that. And the important thing here is that you get to see the alternate build, at least one possible alternate build. And this is a pretty cool one if you really take some time to look at and understand what you're looking at. Notice you've got a hinge right here. So these dual panels, these dual dishes, can lean way back, probably back to about 45 degrees. You've got a little computer screen right there. You've got a pair of the little step ladder kind of things that allow you to get up to here, sit right there in front of this panel, probably control the whole thing. The whole thing is on a turntable, which is right there. This is one of those large rocket motor pieces, so a nice cone keeping this thing up in the air. So the whole thing can rotate around and it can flip back and forth, so you can really search for things in the sky or make a good connection with a satellite or something. And then it uses the trans yellow piece, instead of for a roof, uses it for a floor, so you can see through there if you're doing some sort of geological survey and want to look directly beneath the vehicle. Maybe that's actually has a filter, so it shows only certain spectra. And then you actually put this, that's very interesting that they took this inverted windscreen piece and put it up on its side, so it makes it really tall in the front. Cool, so very nice alternate build, very nice main build. I'm very happy to have gotten this set finally after looking at it in pictures for so long. It's definitely not quite the same as I expected it to be, but that's not necessarily a bad thing. So thank you very much for watching this video. Hope you enjoyed that. Hope that you will leave a comment if you have any feedback about this particular set. And I hope that you'll browse around or stick around for more videos from me. Talk to you again soon.